Hello, my name is Nora Rosengarten. I am a curatorial assistant at the Clark, and today I'm going to be talking about a painting from our permanent collection, Victoria Dubourg's Roses in a Porcelain Planter, which was painted sometime between 1875 and 1900. This work is special to me because I was recently able to write the label for it when it moved from storage back into our permanent collection galleries. In this remarkable still life, Dubourg paints a bouquet of roses which threaten to overwhelm the confines of the shallow container in which they have been placed. In fact, one rose has already fallen, visible at bottom left. Dubourg chose warm tones for the roses, pinks, light orange, and red. And in fact, if you look very closely, the application of paint is quite heavy. Every single petal is articulated by the artist applying a great deal of paint to the canvas. This heavy application is in stark contrast with the background, where the artist applied a very thin layer of paint, so thin that you can see the lines that make up the fabric of the canvas. This is called the weave. At bottom right, the artist left her signature, the D, opposite the fallen rose we saw earlier. Dubourg was a French painter. She is best known for still lifes like this one, which depict flowers and fruit. She trained, as did many artists at this time, by copying paintings that were on view at the Louvre in Paris, and went on to have a quite successful career. She would show her paintings at the state-sponsored salons, and she even received awards for her efforts. This success is particularly remarkable given the limitations that were placed on women living in the late 19th century, especially women who wanted to be artists. They had far less access to things like formal training and resources than their male counterparts. Now, flowers were considered an appropriate subject for the female artist, but it's also important to remember that many male painters of this same time period also painted flower still lifes. Dubourg approaches the subject with tremendous virtuosity, as we have seen, and it makes her paintings a true delight to stand in front of. One of my favorite details about this painting is actually the signature. Although she married fellow painter Henri Fantin-Latour, she continued to sign her paintings VD, thereby asserting the independence of her paintings from those of her spouse. Thank you so much for joining me today. I sincerely hope that when our galleries reopen, you will take the chance to go see this incredible painting and allow it to enchant you as it has me.